What is your God's name? Part 30. I'm Professor Hannes Rettinghuis of the First Assembly of Jehovah, South Africa, Pretoria, Montana. Should you require any of the books which I've written, especially the book, What is your God's name? The one, the study that we are currently busy with. It's just good to have a book available so you can follow it in the book as well. Contact us at our WhatsApp number 0722 367 124. Just go to our website https://yahvah.co.za. This is the first time that you'll be watching or following the study, you are most welcome. Hallelujah. But I urge you to go to part one, start from the beginning, because you have missed quite a bit of information that we have already dealt with. It's very important to subscribe to the channel. This is free and it's necessary to be notified about all the other studies that we are busy with, especially our TikTok messages as well. Send this link to your family and friends. Make sure you have a Bible ready, pen and paper to make notes. It's very important to note that we do not associate ourselves with the following people, any messianic groups: Israel Vision Groups, the Hebrew Roots Movement, the Sacred Name Movements. We are not part of the Yah Movement, Jehovah Witnesses, or Seventh-day Adventists. We are not affiliated to any church, denomination, group, or organization in the world. Instead, we are only an end-time Bible study group functioning throughout the world. We are mainly using the ancient Hebrew Sacred Name Bible according to the 1860 restoration of the original Sacred Name Bible, the Rottenham version, the one that was translated by Dr. Joseph Briant Rottenham in 1860. One of the oldest English stroke Hebrew Bibles you will ever lay your hands on. This is not the Emphasis 1902 Bible. Please, it's not the same Bible. According to the restoration of the original Sacred Name Bible, the name Jesus was originally Yahushua. The name God was originally Elohim or Hashim. The name of the Lord was originally Yahweh. The name of the Holy Spirit was originally Ruach HaKodesh. We do not refer to ourselves as Christians, but as Yahvist, according to 1 Peter 4 verse 16, in the restoration of the original Sacred Name Bible. May this message study be a blessing unto you in the wonderful name of Yahushua, our Redeemer and Savior. We are going to continue where we left off last week. John 17 verse 14. John 17 verse 14. Oh, I have given them, which is, look at my fingers, the bride of Yahushua, and even in this 21st century, thy word. And the world have hated them, because they, that's the bride, are not of this world. Hallelujah. Even as I, that's Yahushua, are not of this world. The bride of Yahushua will always walk in what? In faith. We are saved by grace. And the other, some time ago I said that grace has got a name. Grace has a name. And that name is Yahushua. Hallelujah. So we walk by faith through grace in the name of Yahushua through the teachings and leading of the Ruach HaKodesh. Hallelujah. Verse 15. I pray not that thou should have taken them, that's the bride of Yahushua, out of the world. We don't want to take shortcut. Take them out of the world so they be relieved. No, 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 no. We are here. We've been placed here to make a difference in the world outside. That's what Yahweh's placed us here for. But that thou, Yahweh, our Elohim, should have kept them, that's the bride, from the evil. So what does he do? He protects us from evil. It is wonderful to realize that Yahushua, our Redeemer and our Savior, is constantly interceding and praying for his bride. Where is he sitting? What does the Bible say? Where is Yahushua sitting? On the right hand of the Father. Why? What does he do? He's our high priest. He intercedes for us on a daily basis. Verse 16. They, the bride of Yahushua, are not of the world. even as I, Yeshua, am not of this world. He was not of the world. That's why they hate him. He wouldn't associate with sin. He preached a standard of holiness. And that's why I say, we as the bride of Yahushua is not of this world. We are not to participate in the world. Why? Because our name has been have been reinstalled by the blood of Yahushua through grace, especially after we were immersed in the name of Yahushua to the forgiveness of our sins. Acts 2:36, 41. The bride of Yahushua should not live according to this world. We don't want to live to the world. We should be sanctified by the blood of Yahushua. Are we sanctified? We are redeemed. We're sanctified. We are made holy. Why? Because the Bible says that we are what? He says that we are an object of worship unto Yahweh our Elohim. How? Through this sanctified blood of Yahushua. We've been redeemed by the blood. We've been washed by the blood. We've been saved through the blood. The blood and the water, they're together. That's how new birth happens. First the sign of the blood, then breaking of the water. First coming to Yahushua through his blood, then immersing in the name of Yahushua. You can't separate the two. The water and the blood, they are like one. And that's why when the soldier put the spear into Yahushua after he died, he says water and blood came out. Water and blood. Hallelujah. He says, verse 70, sanctify them in the truth. This is my scripture. Sanctify them in thy truth. Thy word is the truth. And the devil doesn't like it. Satan doesn't like it. He doesn't want you to live in truth. He doesn't want you to know the truth. And that's why I'm doing the study. I could have preached any message. But in the time we are living in this 21st century, we need to come to the revelation of Yahweh's word. He's going to appear on the clouds with the parousia. He's coming to call us to be with him. When we will be changed, 1 Corinthians 15:27 to 58, we will be changed from mortal to immortality and from an earthly body into a heavenly body. We will meet him in the air. That's what the word says. Hallelujah. In a twinkle of an eye. That's not for the world. That's not for Israel. That's not when he comes. It's not the same happening as in Revelation 19 verse 6 to 15. No. When he comes on a white horse with a sword to make war against the Antichrist. The sword is not in his hand. In his mouth. Why is the sword in his mouth? Because he's going to speak judgment. He's going to speak judgment over the Antichrist and the people and the two-thirds of Israel who hasn't accepted him as the Messiah and Savior. When he died on Calvary's cross, when he says, Father, is fulfilled, in our hands I laid my spirit, and he's given the breath. He's won every war. When he ascended into Hades and he returned and was caught up into heaven, he has won every war. He doesn't need to win any war. So when he comes, he's coming to set his foot on Mount Olives, not Mount Zion, as the church taught us, Mount Olives. He comes to set his foot on Mount Olives, which is the mountain opposite Mount Zion, where the Dome of the Rock is the temple currently. So he's not coming on Mount Zion, which is actually Mount Moriah. On another stage, I'm going to do a study so that you can understand what I'm saying now. But he's coming on the Mount Olives. And the mount will split in two, from the east to the west and from the south to the north, from the north to the south. And that will become the Valley of Armageddon. That's where the Battle of Armageddon will take place. So when he comes on his white horse, you find a multitude of people in fine white lined clothes. Who are they? That's the bride. Also on white horses. Why white horses? Why is Yahushua riding symbolically a white horse? Because in John's time, 2000 years ago, only a king and an emperor rode a white horse. Yahushua is the King of Kings. And why is the bride also on white horses? Because the word says we are kings, sons and priests of Yahweh. And even on this earth we are reigning as kings already. How? We are reigning over the evil force and works of Satan. And that's why he doesn't like us. Doesn't matter. We live by faith. We live in the truth. Sanctify them in the truth. Do you want to know the truth? That's why I'm preaching this word. Some have started to listen and they left off because it's too much for them. Because the Bible also says, it's not everyone that says, Lord, Lord. Now you know by this time that the word Lord means Baali, which is a pagan god. So, he's coming for his bride. And the word says, sanctify them in the truth. It's either the truth or the lie. And like I said, I'm not getting paid to preach these teachings and teach you about the word. This is free. This is not a church. It's a Bible study. Sanctify them in the truth. Thy word is the truth. Apostle Paul urged the bride of Yahushua to be true to the word of Yahweh, his Elohim. In the wilderness of Judea, driven forth in the spirit and power of Elijah, my El is Yah. The immerser, baptizer, called out, repent ye, for the kingdom of heavens are drawn near. For this is he who are spoken by the prophet Isaiah, saying, the voice of one crying in the wilderness, Yahushua, prepare the way of the Lord. It's not the Lord. And if you have a 1611 King James Bible, look at that word Lord. Why is it spelled in capital letters? Did you know that? Have you ever picked that up? It says Lord, L-O-R-D, all in capital letters. Can you tell why is it all in capital letters? I'm sure you're supposed to do, because the word Yahweh, Yahweh is all capital letters. And the fact that they are written in the word Lord in capital letters in the 1611 King James Bible makes a declaration that the name Yahweh in the original scriptures was all capital letters. He says, prepare the way of Yahweh. Make his path straight. Matthew 3 verse 2 and 3. Make a note. Matthew 2 verse 3. Matthew 3 verse 2 and 3. Luke 1 verse 17. And Isaiah 40 verse 3. There's your scriptures. Hallelujah. After studying all these scriptures, it has become evident that we as bride of Yahushua were robbed of our inheritance in the world. We've been robbed of our inheritance in the word of Yahweh our Elim and of all original ancient Hebrew sacred names. Can you imagine if we, 50 years ago, we came to the knowledge of this revelation name? We could have flooded the world with the truth of the gospel. Millions of people could have been saved. But the question must be, but why didn't it happen? You know, life work in circles of seasons. And as life has seasons, nature has seasons, so does Yahweh have seasons. And this is the season of the truth. And that's why the word says, that's why he has said, sanctify them in the truth. John 17:17. Thy word is the truth. Ancient pagan idols and Christian religions. Yach, now you must tighten your seatbelt. In the introduction of the Holy Name Bible, page V, we find the following. Now this is a reference. In the introduction of the Holy Bible, page V, we find the following. The name of the Son, Yahshua. Not Jesus, Yahshua. Has been substituted by Jesus, Isaias, and Zeus. Healing Zeus. Zeus is who? The sun god. Which in Egypt was Ra. Ra, Zeus, or Zara. Then the Greek god Zeus, which became Isios, which became Jesus. Webster dictionary says that Zeus is the sky god, the sun god, and is also known as Deus in Latin, Dew in Latin, Italian, Dios in Spanish, Bios, Sanskrit, and Zeus, stotter meaning Zeus, the savior, for the French Bible has substituted Dew. Hallelujah, what information. There's the information. The ancient nations were mostly heathen sun worshippers. Many, many years. That's why you find your Greeks. Well, we start with Babylon. Actually, you can start with Nimrod. Genesis 10. Sun god worshippers. That's why they wanted to build a tower to reach to the throne of Yahweh. The ancient nations were mostly heathen sun worshippers. Worshippers of the sun has its origin in Egypt to a large extent and is described very intensely by Ralph Woodrow in his book Babylon's Mysteries, Religion, page 39 to 46. So there's your research. Isaiah 65 verse 11 is quoted from the Holy Name Bible as follows. Listen. The Holy Name Bible, Isaiah 65 verse 11. But ye are they that forsake Yahweh. Yahweh. Why Yahweh? It's Yah or Yaffa. Currently written, that forgot my holy mountain. That prepare a table for the deity of fortune. Lotto and playing lotto and roulette and whatever you need. See footnote, Hebrew Gavad, G-A-W-D. It means English God. And that finished the drinking offerings unto destiny. Hebrew meaning the deity of fortune. Meuni. M-E-N-I, meaning the destiny of fortune. The above clear indicates that negative sense in which Almighty regards worship of the sun and other idols. Zeus was the sun god for the Greeks in the same way Jupiter was a sun god for the Romans. Exactly the same guy, just other names. The substitution for the name of Yahweh, Yah or Yaffa, currently written, and Yahshua by the names of the pagan deities of the nations cause immeasurable harm. This is what they do. But that's the work of Satan. Such names as Lord, God, Jesus and Christ is in no way respect the meaning of the name revealed to the Most High, to Moses, and ancient Hebrew leaders. By using these names, the people unknowingly, they don't know, I didn't know, turn the worship of Yahweh, our Elohim, into that of idol worshipping. And actually as described in the benevolent characteristics of the Mighty One, Yahweh the Elohim. to the pagan deities, the Holy Name Bible, page V, emphasis minor writings. For she did not know that I gave a grain, nor wine, and oil, a multiplier of silver and of gold, which they prepared for Baal, or Lord God, according to Hosea 2 verse 8. If you go and read Isaiah 2 verse 15 and 16 says, you will no longer call me Lord, L-O-R-D, all capital letters, but you will call my husband, my Baali. In verse 16 it says, then I will remove the names of Baali out of your mouth, which is pagan gods. By this name you should not worship me anymore. Hallelujah. Now what's the Baali names? Well, Jesus, God, Lord, Sun God, Nimrod, Ra, Zeus, Isis, they're all the same God. Even Jesus, yes, because there was no letter J in the Greek or Hebrew alphabet ever until the 16th century, 1524 to be exactly. Then the letter J was created. In the next chapter, we will make a study of the only name in the world whereby man can and will be saved. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The name above every other name. Isn't that wonderful that we now know the name above every other name? Yes, all my life. I thought that was, well, if I say all my life, up to the last 13, 14 years, I thought it was Jesus. I would have died for the name Jesus. I didn't knew better. You know why? Because we didn't translate the Bibles. We grew up with the names, and we were as youngsters, were made to respect that name. You're not to swear in that name or anything. It was, when the pastor speaks the name Jesus, it was like music playing. Because we haven't translated the names into the Bible. Name above every other name. According to the Bible, there is a name above every other name in this world, by which every man or woman must be saved. It is the importance of the discovery of the ancient Hebrew name that will make the difference of whether we are be called the bride of Yahushua, or will he say, go, I that's Yahweh your Elohim, know you not, according to Matthew 25 verse 12, I know you not. So what happened to all the people that died, my father and all the other people that died in the name of Yahushua, believing that it was the only name, like I thought so for 50 years, believing that that was the only name? Are they going to hell? No, it's very easily. It's very easy. They are going to be guests at the wedding feast, at the wedding ceremony. Like in any wedding, there are guests who are invited to the wedding. They're going to see the bride and they're going to see the bridegroom. But who's going to the honeymoon suite after the occasion, after the reception? Does the bridegroom and bride call the mother-in-law and father-in-law, says, come with us, we're going on honeymoon, we're going to, or let me put it the other way, we're going to the bride suite? No, they're going by themselves. Why? Because they are going to unveil themselves to each other for the first time. You understand that? So what's going to happen? Those that did not know the name, the revelation name of Yahweh and Yahshua, the Ruach HaKodesh and Yahshua, they are going to paradise. What happened with the guy on the cross? There's two sinners. The one says, if you are Yahweh, our Elohim, removes us all from the cross. The other one says, Lord, Yahshua, have mercy on me. And he received mercy. It didn't happen in 2 seconds. He must have confessed his sins. And he dedicated his life to Yahshua while hanging there. Because they were hanging there for quite a time before they died. What did Yahshua promise him? Today, I say unto you, today you will be with me where? In paradise. Now, where is paradise? It's not on the earth. Apostle Paul says it's in the third heaven. It's in the third heaven. And paradise is not the seventh heaven. That's not the ultimate. As everything in Yahweh's plan works with sevens, that's his number. The earth and everything was made in 7 days. Seven, seven, sevens. Why wouldn't there be seven heavens or even more heavens than sevens? I believe, according to the Bible, there are much more heavens. Because the word says when Yahshua ascended into heaven, he ascended past all the heavens. You with me? So, after the marriage ceremony, after the occasion, the bride and the bridegroom leaves the occasion. All those that served Jesus Christ as we knew him in holiness all their lives, they're going to be part of the guest. They are in heaven. They sing the bride. They sing the bridegroom. They are in heaven. They are in paradise, in third heaven. They're not in Hades. They're nowhere else. They have made it. But the bride and the bridegroom is going into the suite. Because Yahshua explained to Nicodemus, you can go and read John 3 verse 1 to 21. In verse 3 and verse 5, Yahshua said to Nicodemus, very, very, verily, he swears. He emphasized, verily, verily, I say unto you, Nicodemus, if you are not born again of water and spirit, you will not see the kingdom of Yahshua, of Yahweh. You will not see it. What is this kingdom? Then Nicodemus says, how do I go back in the womb of my mother and be born again? No, it's not what I mean. In verse 5, again, Yahshua swears. He says, Nicodemus, very, verily, I say unto you, if you are not born again of water and spirit, you will not enter the kingdom. Now, that sounds like if you are not immersed or baptized, you cannot go to heaven. You cannot see the heaven, you can't go to heaven. It's not what it means. The translation has been incorrectly done. That means it's the bride's and the bridegroom's suite, if I might call it that. You cannot go into the bride and bridegroom's suite. You need to have a garment on. And that's why Galatians 3 verse 26 to 29 says, those that were immersed in the name of Yahshua to forgiveness of this sin have clothed themselves with Yahshua. They put on the wedding garment. That is what the immersing is in the name of Yahshua. It's a wedding garment. That's why we are immersed, and that's why we have to live in holiness, in all righteousness, in truth. Be guided. We must be allowed to be guided by the Ruach HaKodesh of sins and unrighteousness. He will teach and lead us. Why? because he lives within us. Yahweh our Elohim lives within us. He doesn't live in temples which is made by hands. He says our bodies is the temple of the Ruach HaKodesh. He lives within us. Hallelujah. Today in 2024, we are living in the age of the great lie. You won't believe it. You won't believe it. We're living in the age of the greatest lies. If you see all the rubbish that's on internet, and then you look at Wikipedia, somebody can write an article and put it on Wikipedia. I can write an article, put it on Wikipedia. You can come and you can change it. You use my documents and you change it to what you like. Then somebody else can come and they can change your document to what they like. Lies upon lies. And the poor person that reads Wikipedia says, but how is this possible? This is what the Bible says. And then there's the atheist that has written the article after I've written my article. It's an atheist that's changed my article. And you come and you read it. Unknowingly. We're living in the age of the greatest lie. Sin is no longer sin. The devil is the good guy. Very few churches today have a standard of holiness. As long as you join church, you're a member, you attend church once a week or once in 2-3 weeks, and you just pay your tithes every week or every month. That's the most important. Somebody once said you just need to feel good about yourself. When you walk out of church, you just need to feel good. It's not a feeling, it's a lifestyle. Today in 2024, we're living in the age of the greatest lies. And for this reason, it's important to be sure that when we pray, that we pray in the right and the original names. It is all these corrupted names which are used by different denominations and churches, which is the main cause for the spiritual confusion in this 24th century and beyond. As we will continue with the study, it's necessary that I allow the Ruach HaKodesh to open my spiritual eyes in order for the revelation word of Yahweh our Elohim to infiltrate my spirit so that I can be able to experience a full revelation of those words in my personal life. You need to allow the Ruach HaKodesh to open your spiritual eyes. Invite him in. And you know what? Just don't swallow anything that I say. Do your own research. But if I'm wrong, help me right with the scriptures. Not just any Bible, the 1611 King James Bible, or the restoration of the original Sacred Name Bible, the Rotterdam version. Time has caught up with us. Till next time, Maranatha. Yahshua is coming back again. Hallelujah.